Now, in this particular chapter, we'll be implementing an anchor ad unit via GPT, and the goal would be to improve viewability, improve CTR and our ad CPMs. So let's go back to the publisher's website and see, you know, where their existing anchor ad is loading. So let's quickly check in here. Okay, firstly, we're not seeing it load all the time, so that is fine, but it is not via the GPT plugin. It is implemented via custom plugin. So okay, you saw it pop in here, then collapse. So if there's an ad, it should appear, or else it should not. So it's trying to pop in, then it detects, and then it collapses. Not an ideal behavior. What we'll do is we'll implement this via GPT. So, you know, go ahead and search for implementing an anchor via GPT at Google Developers, and this is the first article that we are looking for. We would be using this article to implement the anchor ad unit, and let me tell you what all things we'll need from in here. So firstly, we will need the let anchor declaration. So this is the JavaScript keyword declaration. After that, in here is the comment, we can leave that. So anchor ad slot after we declare the variable. So this is actually the define slot function. We would need that. Now they're doing a nice thing. What they're doing is they're checking the client's width. If it is less than 500, they're loading it as a top anchor. Otherwise, they're loading it as a bottom anchor. What we will do is we will load this as a top anchor, and I'll create a separate ad unit for my publisher. Now, why? We already have an existing anchor unit at the bottom. I do not want to actually, you know, have an ad unit overlapping that. Once our top anchor is working, we can consider of removing the bottom anchor ad unit. Now, if anchor ad unit returns null, or if the device doesn't support, then this is adding a, you know, key value, so we simply don't need that. However, we can simply, you know, activate our inner text just to test in the console, you know, if the interstitial doesn't load, it would give us a message in the console and we'll know, you know, what's the status. After that, this is needed to load a static ad slot. We don't need this. And the next thing we'll need is the script, similar to the interstitial. So this is how we would actually implement the anchor code. At first, I'm creating a new ad unit, naming it anchor, having this ad unit out of page. Okay, no frequency cap, no ad refresh. Okay, this ad unit is created. Now this is named anchor. Now, as usual, this is the publisher's, you know, WordPress backend. But before implementing, so let's go back into the our local WordPress development environment. Okay, I'll just open code. Okay, so we have the interstitial in here. At beneath, we would implement our anchor ad unit. Now, going back to the website, first thing we would need is the let anchor declaration. We can copy paste this below the interstitial. So this would come below the interstitial. After that, anchor ad slot equals to this. So okay, anchor ad slots equal to this. Now let's replace our publisher ID. This is, I was trying something else. So this is also from another publisher. It's not replaced. Let's replace this. Now in here, we would replace our, you know, publisher ID, then the ad unit name. Okay. Now I am simply removing this case because I need to only load the top anchor. So I am copying this and just removing this. Okay, implementing this in here, and this should be all set. Seeing what else is left, Okay, if anchor slot, we can actually initialize this. So if anchor slot, we don't want to implement a key value in here. Let's delete this. Now, one last thing we need is the body code. So for the body code, let's copy this script and implement it in the body. We can implement it after the, you know, interstitial script. Yeah, that is it. Okay, let's now come to our local, open the site and test. Okay, something went wrong. So there was an instructor of mine or a teacher of mine that used to tell me, you know, don't be sad when an error happens. Be happy because you'll get to learn something new. So we would be not discouraged by this. We would solve it together. So we are seeing that this relates to setting inner text. Okay, so we messed up something in here. I mentioned in ChatGPT that I get this error, invalid arguments, and for this code, please help me correct it. Now it has helped me correct this for the code, and I did implement it. So let me implement this. Let's save. Let's go to the website and let's see. Now it did help me correct, but it removed the header code of all the other ad units. So let me ask him to add that. Let's add in the header code manually for the other ad units. So I'm adding the ad code for the other ad units manually, going back in here and not relying on ChatGPT again. So in here, I provide in everything. Now let's go in. Now everything is working correctly and we are seeing the anchor ad unit, that is the 10th ad unit. Now this is the code we have gotten in here and we would apply this to our live site. So what are the changes? Now let's go into the dashboard, code snippets, header and footer. Okay. Firstly would be our let declaration. So let anchor slot. Let anchor slot. Then we would come to the section wherein we are actually defining the anchor slot. Okay, so this was the section wherein our add service function was missing. So this is something we missed and it was causing all the errors. So if anchor returns null, then do nothing. If the add anchor add slot loads, add this service basically. So sometimes, you know, you like mess up simple things and you get an error. But yeah, ChatGPT definitely helps in these errors, but you should be aware of what it's exactly doing, because otherwise it gets difficult. Okay, so this is updated. Let me save this in the Live Publisher's website. Go to restaurant, visit menu, and let's see if we are seeing the anchor. There are overall 10 ad units. Let's see. Okay, we are seeing the anchor ad unit in here. It will load after some time, so I am not actually pushing it to load, because as we observed with interstitial, this might take some time to load. Now this is how you can implement anchor ad unit. So my goal was to teach you troubleshooting along the path, because when you do it on your own, you would encounter these issues. So how can you use ChatGPT to actually, you know, find the errors and fix these issues on your own?